Welcome. So this is going to be the last video in a series I've been filming related to the yamas and the niyamas. So today we arrive at the final two. We'll be working with aparigraha or nonpossessiveness, letting go, and we'll also be working with ishvara, prinidhana, surrender to a higher power. So I find it interesting that this yama and niyama both speak of this quality of letting go, surrender, perhaps in a slightly different way. So I'll be theming this just a little differently than the other videos. In this one, I was really inspired to bring in the elements of nature, because I feel like nature is the best example of surrender and letting go. As I've been walking more and more in the forest this winter towards spring, I've been finding just the results of the winter, a lot of trees down, almost a sense of disorder, but in an orderly sort of way, of just how nature allows whatever to come, to go, and still falls back into the still place. So we'll be cultivating the qualities of nature. I invite you to lie back onto your mat. Once you arrive on your back, just settle into the shape. Perhaps you allow your knees to draw a little bit closer together, your feet a little bit wider. And we'll be diving right in to explore the elements within us. So just allowing your breath to be still, to just be there as you explore the quality of earth, feeling the weight of your bones, the quality of earth, of stillness, patience, simply witnessing the steadiness of the earth within you. And then beginning to deepen your breath, maybe you place your hands on your belly to explore the element of water. As you inhale, feel that belly rise. As you exhale, feel the belly lower. This tidal, rhythmic, fluid quality of the breath, like water. And then maybe rest your arms by your side. Maybe you still feel a little warmth under your belly where your hands were, as we contemplate the quality, the element of fire. So let's intensify that breath. Really feel the belly draw in, maybe pull up lightly on the pelvic floor,
maybe you visualize a flame within your belly. This is in yoga the center of Agni, digestive fire. The place where we transform our food to energy. The place where we transform so much more. Visualize that fire, that flame in your belly. As you deepen that breath now, pulling in on the navel, pulling in on the pelvic floor. The transformative element of fire. And now we come to contemplate the element of air as breath. So sense the breath underneath your nostrils. As you inhale, sense the breath, maybe a coolness. As you exhale, sense that breath, maybe a feeling of warmth, this air element. And notice for you, maybe you notice one side of your nostrils is more clear. If you happen to notice one side is a little bit more blocked, take a moment to address that. My left nostril is a little more blocked, so I'm going to block off the right nostril. This might not be the case for you. Breathe in through the left. Block off both, breathe out through the right. Just a few times. Sense the air moving in, the air moving out. And then settling to observe the breath in both of the nostrils. Air element a little bit more light, but still very involved in our process of transformation and energy. Send your energy today. And then moving into the element of spaciousness. Breathe fully and deeply into all of your body, maybe even sensing the breath can move beyond. As you exhale, simply relax. And just contemplating the element of space, the space all around you. This space with the quality of vastness, maybe compassion, allowing all just as it is. Maybe a feeling of freedom. Beautiful. So we'll be weaving those elements into our physical practice. Maybe you align your feet now to point straight ahead, knees straight ahead. Let's hug just the right knee in towards the chest. Keep the left leg bent. Breathing deeply. First contemplate the earth quality of your body, the stillness, the steadiness, the weight of your bones. This quality of spaciousness. This quality of surrender. Aparigraha, nonpossesiveness. For what do we truly own? Not even this earth do we own. And then hold that knee with just the right hand. Let the left hand fall by your side. Start making little circles. Moving into that element of water. Again, fluid. Flowing. The opposite of stagnant. Moving. And then holding that knee again, we'll bring in the element of fire. So press into your left foot. If your back is a little tweaky today, you might just focus on drawing in those belly muscles, or you could lift up into a little crunch. Feel the fire within your navel center. Let it go. Take a moment to just notice the breath in your nostrils, the air. Breath moving into the lungs. And then to cultivate a sense of spaciousness, maybe you let your left leg fall down. We're gonna do a rabbit kick. So imagine there's something on that right foot and we're gonna kick it off. Continue to breathe deeply, creating a little shake in the body, creating more space, particularly in the hip. And then let it go. Just take a moment to explore, to breathe into the two sides of the body. Notice any subtle differences, any differences in the quality of spaciousness. So now taking the legs back to a bent, we'll do this little sequence on the other side. So hug your left knee in towards your chest. Find the stillness of earth. And aparigraha, nonpossessiveness. Ishvara, prinidhana, surrender. Just like the trees, the water, the ice surrenders to a greater plan. Can we surrender to a greater plan and to the divinity within ourselves? Rest that right arm down. Hold onto the left knee and make some little circles. Water element. Inviting the quality of fluidity, maybe creativity. And then hug that knee in, root into the right foot. Maybe take yourself into a little crunch. You can keep your chest and shoulders down. Intensify the breath, feel that agony, that fire in your belly. Down, relax. Note breath in the nostrils, quality of air, lightness. Then we'll do this rabbit kick on the other side. So straighten your right leg down. Imagine there's something on that left foot and we want to kick it off. Nice and light. Breathing deeply. Making space in our bodies. Maybe making space later on for our thoughts, our minds, our hearts. Then let it go. Take a moment to notice the spaciousness. Beautiful. So now we'll bend our legs in. Trying to find some nice stable earth underneath me for this next movement. So when you're ready, let's hug both of the knees in. Take a moment again to cultivate earth, steadiness, and stillness. Patience. And then start circling those knees in whichever way you're guided to. And the quality of water. Open to creativity, free expression, movement. Maybe circle in both directions. And then from here, again, depending on how your back is feeling, you could kind of stay here, cultivate a little bit of fire by drawing the knees in and out. Or if you're feeling it, you could crunch yourself up into a little ball. Feel that fire, that heat, transformative power. You might stay there, you might reach your legs up to the sky. Little Pilates move. Maybe we cultivate a little bit of the breath element here. So exhale, 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 little pumping quality here. A little fire, a little air. If this isn't serving you, just rest. That alternate rest pose. Just explore once again the quality of spaciousness. So when you're ready, we'll prepare to transition. Let's gently roll to either side. And we're going to find our way into our table position. So once again, finding that quality of earth, find your shoulders over your wrists, your knees as wide as your hips. Find some stillness. Close your eyes. Perhaps feel the structure of your bones, the integrity of this body, of this structure. And then we'll bring in water. Bring into our tabletop. So if you inhale, drop belly, lift heart, lift tail. Exhale, off the spine, draw the belly with your own breath. Again, feeling, even appreciating the ability to move like water
and then coming back to neutral. Let's explore the qualities of air and fire together. So let's extend our left leg straight back behind us. Reach our right arm forward. And if it doesn't serve you to do arm and leg, you can just do this with your leg. But we're going to create a little bit of fire as well as air. So inhale, fully with the air. Exhale, elbow to knee-ish, fire. Elbow to knee. Keep it going. Again, with your breath. Cultivating the fuel that both the air and the fire bring to you. Bring to this world. Hold for a minute. Inhale, maybe lift a little more. Feel the lightness of air. Exhale, just settle. Draw the belly in, fire. Inhale, float up a little more. Exhale, fire. Beautiful. Set it down and take a little break back into your child's pose, contemplating the quality of ready, coming back to your table to do that little sequence on the other side, again to your degree. Always feel totally okay to modify. Extend that right leg back, reach forward with the left hand. Inhale, air. Exhale, elbow towards knee, fire. Keep it going. Qualities of energy. We're moving a little closer towards spring. So that idea of waking up a little bit, cultivating a little bit more energy for transformation. And then hold, you can rest here. Or stay for a little longer. Inhale, air, lift a little more. Exhale, pull belly in, fire. Inhale, air. Exhale, fire. And then when you're ready, step back into your child's pose. Take some nice, deep, spacious breaths in your child's pose. I'd like to offer you a reading here as you rest in child's pose. This is from Deborah Adele, the Yamas and Niyamas. And she speaks of aparigraha, nonpossessiveness. It can also be interpreted as non-attachment, non-greed, non-clinging, non-grasping. We can simply think of it as being able to let go. What if we could trust life like the earth does? Trust life like we trust the breath, air. What if we could take in all the nourishment of the moment and then let it go fully, trusting that more nourishment will come? Just like the breath gives us nourishment, so does life. Aparigraha invites us to practice divine play, experience full intimacy and contact with the moment, and then to let go so the next thing can come. It is how we grow our competency, how we become more of who we are capable of being.
when you're ready, come back to your table. And when you're ready, tuck your toes, draw back into your downward facing dog. This is your downward facing dog, so modify as needed. Maybe think about which one of the elements do you use more in this pose. Maybe it's fire. Maybe it's earth connecting to what touches the earth. Maybe it's spaciousness, finding space in your spine. And when you're ready, mindfully walk those feet forward. And we're going to roll ourselves up nice and slow, coming into our mountain pose. So find your feet wherever they feel just right. Maybe you take your hands in prayer to your heart. Maybe you close your eyes if you feel comfortable. Visualize your bones, your spine, just stacking up, shoulders over hips, ground reaching for sky, feet like the base of your standing mountain. Stability, patience, enduring. Relax your eyes, and let's bring in a little bit of water and air with this nice fluid movement. Inhale, reach up towards sky, feel the lightness of air. Exhale, wave those arms down like water. Keep it going. Inhale, up. Filling with air and lightness. Exhale, waving down. Keep it going. Take that upward gaze, baby back bend, air, lightness, exhale, receding back like the waves in the ocean. Like a moving meditation. Naturally bringing my hand to my solar plexus, a little unsteady ground here, thinking of that fire element. So slow that down when you're ready.
spaciousness within the body, the mind. Then let's reach our hands up over our head. We can make our temple mudra here if this serves you. Point your fingers reaching up towards the sky. Coming back to this earthy element within us. And then let's move like the wind, air. Inhale up. Exhale, wave to the right. Draw the belly in. Let it go. Take a moment to just explore that side of your body in your standing mountain. And then rise up. Take that lateral side bend over to the other side. And whichever arm position is serving you best. Your knee wants to settle down to the earth, perfectly fine. And find the stillness of the earth. Then we'll bring in a little water and air. Inhale, drop knee, lift chest. Exhale, wave back towards here. Inhale, drop down, lift heart. Exhale, wave. Flowing, the optimal word, flow, like water, like the wind. Moving with your breath. And then hold. Again, that back knee can be down. We're going to take a twist. So the left hand roots, the right hand can just come to the hip as we turn to the right, maybe to the sacrum, or can reach to the sky. Find your twist. Our twist has the element of fire. Moving from our center, strong. then we're going to move into the quality of station. So a couple options you might just stay in your lunge, but trying to find some sensation in your left hip. You may take your blocks to the inside and morph a little bit into a lizard type shape. So whatever serves you here. I'm going to take lizard, but you can stay in your lunge. You're taking lizard, careful attention to your body. You might stay right here, hands on your blocks, or you might come down to your elbows.
Breathe deeply,
creating a little bit more spaciousness in your hips. Space has the quality of just allowing, not pushing, pressing, just allowing that opening to come. And when you're ready, come back to center. Take that right knee back. And before we do the other side, take a moment to just rest in child's pose. Again, still contemplating spaciousness. Maybe notice any difference between the two hips. And when you're ready, to the other side, so maybe you take a quick downward facing dog. And walk your way forward. We'll slowly rise on up, taking our mountain. Take a moment to breathe, to feel, to observe. And we'll take that to the other side. Big inhale up. Exhale, hinge at the hips. Gather up your blocks. And this time, we'll step back with our right foot. So taking your lunge, if it serves you, you can keep that back knee lifted, or you can lower it to the ground. But find a place that you can just hold and experience the stillness of the earth. And then we'll bring in a little bit of air, a little bit of water. Inhale, drop knee, lift heart. Exhale, wave those hips back, moving into pyramid. Inhale, down and up. Exhale, wave it. Keep it going. Feeling that water element flow. Creativity. And then hold here. We'll take that twist. Once again, your back knee can be up or it can be down on the earth. Root your right hand. You can take your left hand to your hip, turn to the sacrum, or you can reach that left arm up to the sky. Bringing in the fire element, twist for me, a little associated with fire, that digestive fire, that fire of transformation. When you're ready, bring it down. Drop that back knee. again, find your way into a spacious hip opener. You could just stay right here in your lunge, sinking that right hip a little more. Or you could come into lizard, walking that left foot over to the side, blocks to the inside. Again, a shape that can feel spacious, allowing for a little opening without force.
Of spaciousness, space. What could we need space for? And whenever you're ready,
mindfully keep that left knee back.
And just
come down into your child's pose for a little neutralize.
Continue to contemplate spaciousness. And when you're ready, back into your tabletop. Draw back into your downward facing dog, giving just another point of transition. And walk your feet forward towards your feet. We'll slowly roll on up.
Coming back to our mountain pose. Talk about the transformative power of nature. When I came out here, the sky was white-gray. Now it is blue. Feel your mountain. Spacious breath within you. And we'll just do one more standing pose. So how could we not include tree pose into our practice on the elements? We'll also practice non-possessiveness, just letting go of any perfection in our tree pose. So let's root the left foot to the earth, right foot to the ankle. Find an evenness in your hips. And then allow your tree to morph into its own unique shape, maybe taking foot to the ankle, maybe reaching those hands up to the sky. Breathe. Which element is attracting you here? Maybe it's fire, the focus. We need earth. We need air. Let it go whenever you're ready. And we'll come to the other side. So root that right foot down. Keep your left foot to meet the ankle. Open the knee. This might be your tree today. Strong roots growing towards earth. Or maybe you morph your tree into a different shape. We reaching hands up towards sky for me is always a little gesture of ishvara prinidhana, surrender to the divine. Reaching hands to heaven, towards God. Towards the majesty of nature, knowing that we are not alone. When you're ready, let it go. Come back to your mountain, take a moment to breathe, to feel. And from here, we'll be coming a little closer towards Earth. So towards the top of your mat. Take that big inhale up. Exhale, fold.
Come down onto hands and knees. And we'll be lowering all the way down onto our belly. From here, we've been doing a lot of movement, so let's just take a moment to rest. Maybe stretch hands and feet away from each other, long little gesture of prostration down towards Mother Earth. And then resting for a bit in crocodile, so we might hold opposite elbows, widen those feet, surrender the forehead down to our forehead. Breathe deeply here. I'll be rising up to you, offer you another reading as you simply rest in crocodile. If crocodile doesn't serve you, you can come into child's pose or any other pose that serves you. Crocodile for me has always been a pose of surrender. It's letting go. And let's contemplate now a reading from Deborah Adele related to Ishvara Prinidhana. As we grow ourselves into the fullness of what this jewel, Ishvara Prinidhana, has to teach us, we begin to understand the magnitude of what guides, protects, nourishes, and cares for us. We begin to understand that there is something much greater which is doing us. And we begin to give all of our actions, as well as the fruits of our actions, into the arms of the divine. Surrender is knowing ourselves to be part of this divine oneness, and then giving ourselves over to this greater whole. We find in the process that we do not lose ourselves, but instead become part of the greatness itself. Ready, take your hands by your shoulders. We'll be bringing in that water element, maybe a little bit of air to lift us up, moving in and out of our low cobra. So inhale, lift your heart any amount. Exhale, lower. Keep it flowing. Inhale, like water. Exhale, flow. Sometimes this can be kind of like our spiritual growth. We move forward and we receive that. Without any judgment. Knowing that underneath the water, even in its deepest place, is the steadiness of earth. The unending quality of patience. provided by the earth to support us as we grow.
Lower down.
And let's bring in just a little bit of fire here. So stretch your arms forward. And we'll be doing just a little subtle cross pattern. From inhale into your left toe, your right hand up, inch or two. Exhale, set it down. Inhale, left hand, right foot. Exhale, set it down. Keep it going. With your own breath, then bringing in just a little bit of that fire element, a little bit of warmth and strength into those back muscles. And then maybe we build just a little intensity by holding, not trying to get too high, just hold and breathe. Let it go. Take it to the other side. Hold and breathe. Give the earth a hug, knowing that as you hug her, she's hugging you back. If it's comfortable, turn your head in the other direction. And feel your breath fill you up. When you're ready, coming back to your table, we're just going to be transitioning into a comfortable seat for a short meditation. So I'm definitely going to bring a block underneath me here. So if I can level out the earth. There we go. So find your comfortable seat. Whatever that looks like to you, for you that might even look like sitting up into a chair. Rest your hands on your thighs, lengthen your spine. As we now become a seated mountain, contemplating the qualities of earth. Qualities of earth, such as aparigraha, nonpossesiveness. Who possesses this earth below us? What do we possess that's truly ours? Feel the
quality of earth, of stillness, patience, and simply witnessing everything. And then bringing in the element of water. And the element of water is movement. So start to move your body. You can keep your eyes closed and let this be really intuitive. Maybe you rock back and forth. Maybe you circle just a bit. Maybe you circle your head. And the element of water. Flexibility, creativity, moving through, maybe relaxation, continue to breathe deeply, feeling the container of your body like the earth. But the fluid quality that resides within it, even within your mind. And then bringing in the element of fire. Maybe you visualize a fire within your belly, or you reach your arms up to the sky. Visualize yourself now as the flame, still a moving flame, swaying like the crackling of a fire. Maybe you visualize the colors of red and yellow, orange. The transformative power of fire, the flame, can respond in a way that serves you. If your arms are tired, just set them down and visualize that flame within you. Or become this human flame. A bit primal, ancient. Lie down, hands back to rest on the knees. Come back now to contemplate air. Feel the breath at your nostril. Sense the air, the wind all around you. The lightness. Air and fire coming together to transform. Allow your body to become still once again. Allow the breath to move into all of your body, coming back to the quality of spaciousness. Maybe lift your heart a little bit more, contemplating ishvara, prinidhana, surrender. Surrender to higher purpose. Surrendering the efforts of your practice. God, to nature. You don't have to have all the answers. Just the belief. The trust that our practice is guiding us individually to a greater good as well as humanity. Focal point here. Just continue to feel your breath move into the edges of your body. Maybe feel an energy at your crown. It's a connection to source. Simply sit with yourself. The elements in the unknown. And maybe you hit the pause button. The weight of your bones right here, earth. Changing sides, stretch them off. Hug the other knee in. Relax across your face, your jaw, your shoulders. Maybe a final movement of your choice. Maybe you just like to stretch out and do a little windshield wiper action with your legs. A little bit of a twist. Contemplating all of those elements within yourself. Maybe this movement reminds you of that wave-like quality of water. Maybe you're still feeling earthy and spacious. The light flame. Fire. Just transforming one moment.
good to end our practice with an inversion. So just a short inversion of your choice. You might just reach your feet towards the sky, the leaves. Maybe reach your fingers and toes towards the sky, and you know, water underneath. Change the earth a little bit. You could take supported bridge. You could reach the legs up to the sky here in a little version of legs up the wall. I think I'm going to stay right here. But just find an inversion of your choice. Inversions. Just neutralizing themselves. Like nature and the elements. Sometimes things turn upside down. They're not what we expect. But we still feel the stability of our earth. The stability of our practice. When you're ready, just coming out, bringing in any movements that you might need to neutralize, or setting yourself up for shavasana. Come to seated so I can guide you through final relaxation, but recalling shavasana is one of the greatest practices in yoga of letting go, practicing aparigraha, non-possessiveness. Almost like we're returning back to the earth element. Also a practice of ishvara, prinidhana. And surrendering all of our actions and our non-actions. Sometimes it's in the non-actions, in shavasana, in meditation, where we can feel that biggest tug towards ishvara prinidhana, surrendering mystery. So again, I invite you to settle into shavasana. Bring in whatever props make you feel at ease. Let the weight of your bones become more prominent. And the breath is soft. Maybe with every soft exhale, let your body surrender a little more towards earth. Contemplating your earth element of stillness, patience,
visualize yourself floating in warm water. Anything that doesn't serve, let it flow on and out. Like you're simply watching a stick flow in the stream. Back to the fire, the flame. This time it's just soft. Maybe it's in your belly or in your heart, or wrapping you like a warm blanket. The comfort light moving us out of the darkness of winter to see with fresh eyes. How do we move forward? What do we need to put in the flame? What do we need to keep cultivating? Like tapas. Trust in our practice. Fire. Start to ride a little bit more on the inhalations as we come to contemplate air. Maybe you feel the breath at the nostrils. Maybe you just feel the lightness in your lungs. Promise of the breath of air. The wind to move across you, to energize you. Maybe you feel the linking up. Moving on to spaciousness. Allow the breath to fill every cell with this vitality that the breath brings. space within you, all around you. Feel that quality of surrender in the heaviness of your body, the bone, but also in the lightness of your spirit. Ishvara, prinidhana. As you continue to contemplate this quality of space, freedom within you, I'd like to end with a poem again from the book, Yamas and Niyamas by Deborah Attell. Ultimately, there's nothing I can tell you about surrender. Except having nothing and wanting nothing. Not keeping score, not trying to be richer, not being afraid of losing, not being particularly interested in our own personality. Lullaby of the wind. Just continue to rest in Shavasana.